In this video, we're going to show you how to add a CAD drawing to your FlexSim model. CAD drawings and other images used as backgrounds in FlexSim can be easily imported using the Background Drawing Wizard, found in the menu bar by clicking Tools and then Model Background. The wizard opens up in a new window, and will ask you to specify whether you are importing a CAD drawing or an image file. Make sure the AutoCAD Drawing Radio button is selected, and click Next. The next screen will ask you to specify the path to the CAD file you'll be using. Browse to the file on your computer and click Open. Note that we're using a DWG file. Both DXF and DWG files will work in FlexSim. Click Next again to move to the next screen. On this screen, you can customize which layers of your CAD drawing are visible and even change the color of each layer. If you have any features on the drawing that are not necessary to the simulation model, such as a wall or a door, it might be a good idea to make those layers invisible so the visual space doesn't become crowded. Click Next to go to the final screen, where the drawing will be properly positioned and scaled. There are three columns representing the X, Y, and Z axes, and three rows for each that correspond to the position, rotation, and size along each axis. Set the position along each axis to 0, and you'll see that the origin of the drawing, located at its bottom left-hand corner, is sitting exactly at the center of our model. There is one problem with this drawing, though. It's not properly scaled. We're using feet as the model unit in FlexSim, but this drawing is scaled in inches, so it's much too big. There are 12 inches to a foot, so we're going to have to reduce the CAD drawing's size by a factor of 12. You can see that the size of each axis is 1 right now, so we need to divide 1 by 12 and enter the result as the new size, which would be 0.083 repeating. Don't worry if you seem to be missing numbers after the decimal point. By default, FlexSim is set to 2 decimal places of numeric precision, so any 3s that I type in will automatically be cut off. To see more number precision, click Edit in the menu bar and then select Set Number Precision and choose a larger number. Now you can see that the exact number was there all along, it simply wasn't being displayed. Click Finish to complete the import and exit the wizard. You now have a CAD drawing as your model background. You can do a few more things with your background by opening up its Properties window. To do so, go back to the Background Drawing Wizard and click the Skip Wizard button. The drawing is a FlexSim object now, and can be edited through the Quick Properties pane, and it can even have triggers. If you uncheck the No Select box, you can move your CAD drawing in the model view, just as you would any other object. Thank you for watching. For more information on FlexSim products, or to view more tips and tricks for successful modeling, please visit www.flexsim.com.